Flash fill is another tool that can be used to separate columns. To make our lives a bit easier, I've captured some of the stuff here. But if you haven't heard of flash fill, here's my column. I can go next to it. I type what I want to see based on that one. So I'm going to say I want to see JHB. I highlight it. I go to data. I click flash fill. And you'll see it immediately goes, identifies the patterns, and does the same thing. So over here, I've written that code there. I can highlight it. I can push CTRL E, which is the shortcut. And you'll see it does the same thing. Over here, I can either type a 1, and then when I push CTRL E, it gives me that. Or alternatively, I could have put an apostrophe 001. And you'll see now it brings through it as if it was text. Flash fill can also be used here. So you'll see I've typed out what I expect to see, ceramic insulators. I highlight it, data, flash fill, and you'll see it pulls it through even though it's different lengths. Same with this, I've typed what I expect to see here. I click flash fill, and you'll see it gets it right. And so we can continue. I've typed the 220 from here. I highlight it, data, flash fill, and you'll see it does it correct. In this example, same thing, branch and bank account number. What's very important is we want the bank account number to include the zero and must be all the numbers. So we mustn't let Excel think it's a number. So for the first one, I type the branch number. I highlight it. I can go Control E. You'll see it brings it through. But for this one, notice that I typed a number, but I included an apostrophe in front of it, telling Excel it must be text. I can highlight it, and when I say flash fill, you can see that it includes the zero up front and includes all the numbers.